There are a significant percentage of us using the Sirius topography. But do we know how to read and interpret it? This video is all about a practical way of reading these maps and using this topography. The Sirius topography has a Placido disk and a Scheimpflug camera with the measurements and indices derived from both the components. The multi-map contains a curvature, elevation and pachymetry maps. But before we start interpreting, we must first verify the patient details and quality of acquisition. The multi-map should always be interpreted along with the summary indices, which gives us the pupil size, its offset, which is similar to angle kappa, position of apex keratometry, and thinness pachymetry. These give us visual cues on the symmetry of the curvature and pachymetry map. Anterior and posterior keratometry at various pupil sizes are displayed below the summary indices. This is a very useful tool for understanding the curvature and planning toric IOLs. Keratometry and pachymetry are used by us in several scenarios. But how repeatable are these measurements for the same eyes? Data from our study shows that the within subject repeatability with Sirius topographer can be up to 1 diopter for keratometry and up to 10 micron for pachymetry. Hence, we recommend taking at least 3 measurements per eye every time. Apart from the visual cues of symmetry, we require various screening indices to identify keratoconus. SIF and SIB describe the vertical asymmetry of the tangential curvature maps. In the elevation maps on Pentacam, we look for numerical cutoff values of elevation from the best fit sphere. Is it similar on Sirius too? No. The difference in regularity from a best fit toric A-sphere is given by delta Z, which is not true elevation. Some of us use a cutoff of 7 and 12 microns for anterior and posterior surfaces, though it is not recommended. At present, we can at best look for coincidence of areas of steepening, thinning and elevation to make better use of the elevation maps, and use KVF and KVB indices derived from the elevation data. KVF and KVB denote the maximum anterior and posterior elevation points from the reference surface. The deviation of corneal shape from the A-sphere at 4 mm or the 8 mm zone is described by root mean square deviation per unit area, RMS by A. The usually altered corneal aberrations in ectasia, coma, trefoil and spherical aberration are combined into an index for the front and the back surface, the BCVF and BCVB.